deschide. Bucuru deschide, bucuru deschide. Resete bucuru deschide, rete boru deschide, resete bucuru deschide. Rete boru deschide, resete te te ke te te ke te boru deschide. Rete boru deschide, rese bucuru deschide, rete te te. Boru deschide, deschide. Rete boru deschide, rete te te. Rete boru deschide, resete te 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 bucuru deschide. Rete te te boru deschide, rete boru deschide, resete te te te. Rete boru deschide, rese potu kuru deschide boru deschide. Rete te boru deschide, rese te bucuru deschide, rete te te boru deschide. Rete boru deschide, rese potu kuru deschide. Rete te 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 boru deschide, rese te bucuru deschide, rete boru deschide bucuru deschide, rete te 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 boru deschide, rese bucuru deschide boru deschide boru deschide deschide, rete te te ke te te ke te te, rete boru deschide. Oh, thank you Jesus for tonight. Rete boru deschide, rese te, thank you Father for this. Rete boru deschide, rete boru deschide, rese te 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 bucuru deschide, rete boru deschide, rese te te bucuru deschide, rete boru deschide, rete boru deschide, rese te bucuru deschide, rete te te boru deschide, rese te te ke te te ke te te ke te te, rete boru deschide bucuru deschide. Rete boru deschide, bucuru deschide, rese te 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 te, rete te te, rete boru deschide, rese bucuru deschide, rete boru deschide, bucuru deschide, rete te 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 boru deschide, rete boru deschide, rete boru deschide, rese te bucuru deschide, rete te 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 boru deschide, rese bucuru deschide, rete te 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 te. Rete boru de rese bucuru deschide, rete te ke te te ke te te ke te te ke te te, rete boru deschide, rese bucuru deschide bucuru deschide. Tele poco salabas, lekete le mende kele prokos ya talabaros. Masi ke tele poco ya talabaros. Riba ba 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 kase ketele poko sita la masu. Masi ketele poko shiata la baros. Riba ba 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 kase ketele poko salamande. La broko siata la baret. Masi ketele poko shiata la masu. Ketele poko shiata la baros. Riba ba 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 ba. Asikete le poko sheta la baros. Ibra kasikete le poko sheta. Asikete le poko sheta la mas. Riba ba 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 kasikete le poko sheta la baros. Sikete le poko sheta la mando. Sikete le poko sheta la baroko sa ba ba ba. Rete de poco se te da mando. Rete de poco se te da mando. Libra casquete de poco se te da mando. Ripa pa 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 cale proco se te da barus. Licata la barroco se te da mando.
Rete te 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 Siketele pokosieta da baros. Libra pasiketa le pokosieta da baro katala mas. Siketa le pokosieta da pa 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 pa. La pa 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 pa. Siketa le pokosieta. Siketa le pokosieta la barit.
Rete poto corodos kide, rete poto corodos te porodos te, rete poto corodos.
Asi ke tele poko sieta la baros.
Rete
poto
corodos te, rete poto corodos kide, rete te, rete te, rete poto te corodos kide.
Ke tele poko sieta la pa 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 pa. Cassette le cosa la parus. Massicette le poco si at la parus. Papa, 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 la papa, papa, le poco si at.
Rete poto corodo
ke, rete poto se le poco si te la baroko sa ba ba ba, la ba ba ri ba 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 cosa ba le cosa. Rete le poco si te la mas.
Rete poto corodo che
rete le poco se te la paros ri pa 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 rete le poco se te la paroco se te la paros ri pa 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 rete le poco. Masikete le brokos. Masikete le brokos. Masikete le brokos yata la baros. Libra kasikete le brokos yata la baros. Masikete le brokos. Rekete le brokos yata la mas. Masikete le brokos. Rete poco siete la baros.
Rase poto corudo soto poto corudo kere de borudo kadi rete borudo
Rete borudo sete. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Now, let's have the Lord's Prayer. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's read together. Matthew chapter 6, verse 9-19. After this manner, therefore, pray. Thy kingdom come.
Thy will be done in heaven. Give us our daily bread. And forgive us our debts. As we forgive our debtors, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever. Amen.
Let us begin to pray. And now we just lay more emphasis on the last verse that says, it says that deliver us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Let us begin to pray.
Tareba baba, le Baba,
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's take our anchor, Book of Zephaniah, chapter 3, from verse 13. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Let us read together the book of Zephaniah, chapter 3, from verse 13 to 20. Praise the Lord. The remnant of Israel shall not do
iniquity,
nor speak lies,
shall a deceitful tongue be found in their mouth.
For they shall
eat and lie down, and none shall make them afraid.
Sing, O daughter of Zion,
shout, O Israel,
be
glad and rejoice with all the heart,
O daughter of Jerusalem.
The Lord
hath taken away thy judgment.
He hath cast out thy enemy.
King of Israel, even the Lord is in the midst of thee. Thou shalt not see evil anymore.
In that day
it shall be said to Jerusalem, fear thou not, to Zion, let not thine hands be slack.
The Lord
thy God in the midst of thee is mighty. He will save thee, rejoice over thee with joy. He will rest in his love.
Over
thee with singing.
I will gather them that are sorrowful
before the solemn assembly
of thee, in whom the reproach of thee was a burden.
Hallelujah. Let us begin to pray the anchor verse by verse. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, Oh, rase te po koro do kai.
Rintele barahanta le koshanta raba. Rele te le kreba babante. Maschanta rebe babahanta le koshanta raba. Rele kete rele kreba babahanta le koshanta. Sare te le baba. Maschanta rebe baba baba konte. Le reke keke ke. Iyanta rebe baba baba le ko. Ali baba baba koshanta le baba baba. Shakara baba hara loko shantala baba iyan talibe baba bako shara relikente lekribe baba hata loko baba rikashet libe baba lekrabata mashanta rebebe bali baba hata loko relikente iyan talibe baba baba leba shekete liba koshaka relente libe baba baba iyan talibe bako shakra jaliba relikente iyan talibe baba baba Saluko le kerebe ibe baba rebata masha rebe bale kute le baba bata le baba reshe ke kute le baba masha rata le baba kusata le baba ihel tili be baba bale kura baba bata le baba masha rata le baba baba ihel tili be baba kusata rata le baba baba reshe rata le kura baba bata le kusata baba masha rata le baba rele ke kute ihel Le baba baba koshakata, le baba le kraba baba le baba baba hatalo koshakata, mashanta le kraba baba, iyanta le baba baba koshata, rele kekete, iyanta le baba baba koshakata, bale le baba le baba le kraba le baba, shakranta le baba baba hatalo koshakata, rete le kekete, le baba baba, le baba le baba le kraba baba. Baba de cura baba hatalo koshata baba asharate de cura hatalo baba hatalo koshata rele keke ishatale baba bale kote baba baba asharate de cura hatalo koshata rele baba asharate rele poto guru de cura rele keke keke de cura koshata baba baba le keke baba baba hatalo koshata baba asharate Baba
Yeah, let's go to the book of Isaiah 25. We'll read from verse 1 to 12. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Let us read. O Lord, thou art my God.
I will praise thy name, for thou hast done wonderful things. The counsels of God are faithfulness and truth. For thou hast made of a city
a heap of a different city, a ruin, a palace of strangers to be no city. They shall never be built. Therefore shall the strong be glorified.
The city of the terrible nations shall
fear thee. For thou hast been a strength to the poor,
a strength to the needy
in his distress,
a refuge from the storm,
a shadow from the east, when the blast of the nose of the terrible ones is as a storm against the wall.
Thou shalt bring down the noise of strangers, as the heat in a dry place, even the heat of the strangers, the blanch of the terrible ones shall be brought, and in this mountain shall the Lord of hosts make a feast of things full of wine, on the leaves will refine.
And he will destroy
the face of the covering cast over all people,
and the veil that is spread over all people, and he will swallow death in victory, and the Lord will wipe away tears from his face, and the rebuke of the people shall be cut away from all the earth,
for the Lord has spoken it,
and it shall be said in that day.
This is our God, we have waited for him, and he will save us.
We have waited for him,
we will be glad and rejoice in his salvation. For this mountain shall the hand of the Lord rest,
and he shall spread forth his hand
in the midst of them, as he has spread forth his hand, and he shall bring down their pride together with the spoils of their hands, and the fortress of their life. Shall he bring down and bring to the ground, even to the dust,
bring to the ground, even to the dust. Hallelujah! Praise the Lord. As we pray, I want us to pray strongly. But you know, all the scripture here is very powerful. I want us to have in mind as we pray that let God remove this snare or this scourge of COVID-19 from the face of the earth. And also, if you look at verse 6, it says there, and on this mountain shall the Lord of hosts make unto all people a feast of fat things, a feast of wines on the lees, of fat things full of marrow, of wines on the lees well refined. Hallelujah. I believe this is talking about a special anointing. Hallelujah. That's why it says well refined. Whenever you hear of wine, it's talking about a special anointing that God will release. And the fatness, I believe, is talking about we're going to walk in a revelation, special revelation of the word of God in the in the mountain, that is on the mountain, on Mount Zion, on the body of Christ. And then he now says, when that happens, when that anointing, that special anointing starts to flow, verse 7, and he will destroy in this mountain the face of the covering cast over all people and the veil that is spread over all nations. Hallelujah. So the mountain from that mountain is where the solution will come. Hallelujah. From that mountain, I believe that's right. So as we pray, let's also ask God for that special refined wine, that special refined anointing, hallelujah, that will come upon the body of Christ, that will make them now to be effective, hallelujah, so that this thing will be fulfilled according to his word. Let us pray. Recite pokoro do sita
teleba taloko shantaraba
telebra
telebaba bale kraba taloko shantaraba releke kente ya talebaba bale kwa shantaraba sharan talekre baba hatale ebeba bale kraba taloko shanta mashan tarebe bale kraba taloko shanta ebeba bale tale kwa shikate baba talebaba
Rete boru
Le papa Praise the Lord. In that verse 4 of the same chapter, he says, "For thou hast been a strength to the poor, a strength to the needy in his distress, a refuge from the storm, a shadow from the heat, when the blast of the terrible north is as a storm against the wall." Hallelujah. So we're going to pray. You see, God knows that from that anointing, we are supposed to draw strength and protection. Hallelujah. And we're going to pray. This is very important, and I want us to pray seriously for all intercessors, for strength and protection, for all our family members, for strength and protection, in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes. He says, God, this is a promise, that is the needy from this distress and a refuge from the storm. Hallelujah. We know we're in a storm. That's why it's called first wave, second wave. That's the that is the terminologies of storms. Hallelujah. So we are going to pray that God should give the refuge and strength to the intercessors, to the body of Christ, to our families, in the mighty name of Jesus. From this special anointing, hallelujah, let us pray.
Ate borude se te bucă pe dorite, 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 ate
Let's go to the book of Micah, chapter 4, verse 1. The book of Micah. Hallelujah. Micah, chapter 4, verse 1. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Let us read. It says, but in the last days, it shall come to pass
that the mountain of the house of the Lord shall be established, and it shall be exalted above the hills, and the people shall flow unto
it. Hallelujah. This is the determination of the heart of God. But we know, the Bible says, if the foundation is destroyed, what can the righteous do? It is the plan of God to establish his church. But the enemy is going after the foundations. Hallelujah. So we are going to pray in the name of Jesus. Particularly, we are going to pray for God to correct the error in the doctrine in the body of Christ. Because you see, if the doctrine is corrupted, you are going to have corrupted disciples. Hallelujah. That's just the truth. So we are going to read, we're going to take one or two scriptures. And then we are going to pray for God to correct some error that has entered into the body of Christ. Let's look at Ephesians chapter 4, verse 14. The book of Ephesians, and we're going to pray that prayer. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 14. Hallelujah. The enemy has changed the doctrine in the body of Christ. And that is why you see children of God, Christians, they don't even know whether they have faith or not. They don't even know whether they are representing Christ or not. Praise the Lord. So we're going to ask God to do something here. Hallelujah. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 4. It says, that we henceforth be no more children, tossed to and fro. And carried about with every wind of doctrine, by the spite of men, and cunning craftiness, whereby
they lie in wait to deceive.
We are going to pray that God should remove all deception, all deceptive doctrine in the body of Christ. I don't know, maybe, let's pray that one, and then I will go now to the next one. And let's pray that God will remove all deception. Hallelujah. That has been brought by these false prophets, these people that are motivational speakers in the body of Christ that are diverting. These are the people that are, the enemy is using to destroy the foundation. Hallelujah, that the church is not established. So we are going to pray that let God remove all deception from the body of Christ. Let us begin to pray. Rasete pokoro
desite le
Ruido que te Hallelujah. You know, one thing is that the personalities that are behind these doctrines, hallelujah, is one thing. God is busy removing them. But you see, the cankerworm is also the, and the palmerworm is also the doctrine. Hallelujah. So sometimes you see when they are, even those four prophets are removed, the people are still in that snare of that doctrine. Hallelujah. So not only that we are going to pray for God to remove the personalities, let God also remove the doctrine. Let's go to the book of Revelation chapter 2. Revelation chapter 2, verse 14 and 20. Revelation chapter 2, hallelujah, verse 14 and verse 20.
Let me just read
from my Bible here. Revelation chapter 2, verse 14. It says, but I have a few things against thee, because thou hast them that hold the doctrine, hallelujah, of Balaam, which taught Balak to cast a stumbling block before the children of Israel, to eat things sacrificed to idols, and to commit fornication. Okay, that's verse 14. Verse 20 says, notwithstanding also, the church in Thyatira, notwithstanding I have a few things against thee, that thou sufferest the woman Jezebel, which calleth herself a prophetess, to teach and to seduce my servants to commit fornication and to eat things sacrificed unto idols. So you see, idolatry is introduced to doctrine. Hallelujah. These are two verses that I've read to you. Now we have that idolatry in the body of Christ. Hallelujah. So we're going to pray as God is dealing with this false prophet. Hallelujah. Let God also deal with this doctrine. And the two things that Jesus told those two churches was they should repent. Hallelujah. They should turn around. They should repent. So we're going to ask God, we're going to repent on behalf of the body of Christ for these doctrines that are going out, that are introducing idolatry into the body of Christ. We're going to repent on behalf of the body of Christ. We're going to ask God to remove these doctrines in the mighty name of Jesus. Because from doctrines come disciples. Rasete kere de sete.
Tele kripli babahanta lokosan. Le kribahan lokosanta. Yanta rebaba gose. Rele kripli babahanta lokosanta. Rele kripli babahanta lokosanta.
free doctrine, Father, introducing idolatry to the body of Christ. Father, Lord, have mercy in the name of Jesus and forgive your church. Cleanse your church.
Rete borudo sete 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 borudo sete
The book of Acts, we're going to look at the book of Acts chapter 20 from verse 27 to 30. The book of Acts chapter 20 from verse 27 to 30. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Book of Acts chapter 20 from verse 27 to 30. Hallelujah. Acts chapter 20, from verse 27 to 30. Let us read. For I have not shunned to declare unto you all the counsel of God. Take heed, therefore, unto yourselves. Unto all the flock over which the Holy Ghost has given you in the overseer, to feed the church of God, which he has purchased with his blood. For I know this, that after my departing shall grievous wolves enter in among you, not sparing the flock. Also, men arise speaking perverseness to our disciples after them. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So we can see there that every doctrine has disciples. So we're going to pray. Jesus always says something. He says, beware of the doctrine of the Pharisees and Sadducees. So we're going to pray for discernment. Hallelujah. In the body of Christ. We're going to ask God for God to open the eyes, hallelujah, and the understanding. Let's just first pray for spirit of discernment in the body of Christ, to for people to understand, to be able to identify these wolves amongst them and in the body of Christ, and to keep away from them. He says, Paul says, take heed, hallelujah. Let us begin to pray that God will begin to give the body of Christ discernment in the name of, because you see, I remember there was this SMS that WhatsApp that is going around about people trying to justify what one prophet, you know, is doing in Nigeria. And you know, those things, if you start to look at the behavior of someone, not knowing what, that the person can be a wolf in sheep clothing, you can't take one thing and leave the other. You cannot take person's behavior outwardly and leave some other area. So we're going to ask for discernment. This is a spiritual exercise. We're going to ask God that God should reveal the wolves, hallelujah, and for the disciples that have gone after them, for them to return back to the right, to the whole counsel. That's what Paul says. Paul said, I have not shown to teach you the whole counsel of God, all the counsel of God. Let us begin to pray and the might for discernment in the body of Christ. Resete pokorodo kudo redeborudo sate rasete pokorodo siteborudo kade rededeborudo sate resete pokorodo kane radeborudo sate resete pokobodorudo kane radeborudo kade rededeborudo sate resete potokorodo kade radede kede 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 resete pokobodorudo kade Resete poto corodo kudo redebo ruido sete rasete tete borudo kade redebo ruido sete poco bodo ruido kade redebo ruido kade redebo ruido sete poco bodo ruido kade rasete poco ruido kade redebo ruido kade redebo ruido kade resete poto corodo kade redete borudo kade redebo ruido kade resete poto corodo kade redebo ruido sete poco bodo ruido kade redebo ruido kade
Second to the last scripture is in Isaiah. Before I hand over to Bishop, it's in Isaiah 29, verse 24. The book of Isaiah, chapter 29. Hallelujah. The book of Isaiah, chapter 29, verse 24. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Now, Pastor Colin. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Okay, we're just going to pray. The book of Isaiah, chapter 29, verse 24 reads, they also that err in spirit shall come to understanding, and they that murmured shall learn doctrine. Hallelujah. Mm. So we are going to ask God that it should bring understanding into the body of Christ and the right doctrine in the name of Jesus. That God should remove murmuring and replace it with a proper doctrine. Say, they that err in spirit shall come to understanding, and they that murmured shall learn doctrine. Hallelujah. Let us begin to pray.
Amen.
Finally, in the book of 1 Timothy, chapter 4, verse 16, 1 Timothy, chapter 4, verse 16, I'm just going to read. It says, take heed unto thyself and unto the doctrine. Continue in them, for in doing this, thou shalt both save thyself and them that hear thee. So this is the mark of the sound doctrine. It should be able to save people. It should be able to bring souls. That's why that scripture says, and souls shall, people shall flow to that mountain. Hallelujah. And they shall begin to tell themselves, let's go to the house of the Lord. They will make a covenant with God. People will be saved. Hallelujah. And then that person that is also preaching it will also save himself.
Also be saved, yeah.
Amen. So we're going to pray for this type of doctrine to be in the body of Christ. In the mind, the one that can bring about genuine salvation. And people should stop being ashamed of the true gospel. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let us begin to pray. The Lord will establish his church in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Bishop, you can close for us.
But you are not done. You haven't taken the confessions. You must take at least six or seven. That's what we said yesterday.
Oh, so okay.
Okay,
maybe.
I don't know if the pastor is awake because it looks like Pastor Collins.
Bishop.
Hello.
I'm here.
Maybe we can continue from where we stopped yesterday in the
No, conference. You start from the beginning. You start from the beginning. I want us to do it systematically and take all of it. So you take five or six, and the next person will start from where you stopped today.
Yeah.
Okay. That's so from yesterday. Let me stay from the beginning then.
Yeah.
Mm. Let's start from the beginning.
That's what I just said. Did I speak Greek?
Okay. Hey. Yeah. Pastor Collins, the victory confessions from number 1 to 6.
Okay.
Praise the Lord. Let's have our victory confessions from the book of Zechariah. Number one, the Lord of hosts is with us in Christ.
International.
The God of
Baba, Precious Lord, amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
We're
going to take a moment to come against the spirit of death. Death in form of COVID-19. Death in form of famine. Death in form of wars and rumors of wars and all this violence you see on the news. We're just going to ask God to intervene. We will never be tired of telling him he needs to intervene. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Remember the parable that Jesus spoke of the widow that kept going to the judge And so once you have that in mind, you will never be tired of asking God that he needs to intervene and intervene quickly in the mighty name of Jesus. 1 Corinthians 15:26. Hallelujah.
Chapter
15:26. The last enemy that shall be destroyed is death. Hallelujah.
Amen. And
we can also look at Hebrews 2:13-15. And again, I'll put my trust in him. And again, behold, I and the children which God have given me. Was much then as the children are partakers of flesh and blood. He himself likewise took part of the same, that through death might destroy the power of death,
that is the devil.
And delivered them through fear of death, all their lifetime subject to bondage. Hallelujah. This scripture tells us clearly that death has been swallowed up in victory. Jesus Christ has laid down his life. He had died so that death could be destroyed. In fact, the person, the one that is in charge of death, the devil himself, is destroyed. And so it's very embarrassing for us as children of God that know these scriptures, that know these facts, to be seeing people die like flies. You know, when we started planting Christ's love in this nation, I remember in Swakop, we were praying. Apostle Seth, you are there, right? You remember? Hello, is Apostle Seth there today? What is sleeping?
He's sleeping.
Okay, but he was there. He was in that team. And we were praying and praying and praying and praying and praying like this in Swakop. And suddenly the Lord said, why are the people dying in this nation like flies? Why are they dying as if he is not in the nation? That was years back. So it's something that should challenge our faith, that is challenging our faith. Because the Bible tells us clearly, Christ has swallowed up death in victory. Hallelujah. And so we are going to stand on that. We are not going to move away from what the Bible has said. We depend upon the power from above. The finished work of Calvary. Here we stand.
We proclaim.
There is victory in his name. Victory in the blood,
of the Lamb.
There is victory in his name. victory in the blood,
of the Lamb.
You know, as the elder was leading us, he was making some serious points. When he took us through Isaiah 25, he was saying that God has promised to anoint the body of Christ. That verse 6, God will anoint us and then he will remove the mask. It will also defeat death. Death will be destroyed. I believe that there is problem, serious problem in the body of Christ, because many of us are unserious. Many of us don't know what we believe. When we pray, we don't know. It's a serious issue. We're going to ask the Lord to deal with us so that we can really, really, really trust him, trust in what he has said. Hallelujah. The believers are lining up for vaccine. Believers are pushing vaccine. Believers are confused. And one of the reasons the Lord is telling us to pray the Lord's Prayer is because he wants to remind us that unless the will of God is done in earth, it cannot be done in heaven, and vice versa. We need to agree with God Almighty about what Jesus has done. Father in heaven, how we love you. We lift your name in all the earth. May your kingdom be established in our praises. As your people, we declare your mighty works. Blessed be the Lord Almighty, who was and is and is to come. Blessed be the Lord God Almighty, who reigns forevermore. Father, we need your help. We thank you because this work is already done.
Amen.
We thank you, Lord Jesus, because you already finished the devil on the cross of Calvary. We thank you because it is written that death is swallowed up in victory. That death has no sting and the grave has no power. Ah, my Father in glory. Abba, Father, we believe you. We believe what the Lord has done for us. For this purpose, the Son of God was manifested, that the works of the devil might be destroyed. We thank you because it is written that he has destroyed him that has the power of death, even the devil. Therefore, what is death doing in the midst of the people? What is death doing on earth, ravaging the people, destroying people, destroyed by violence, by demonstration, by COVID-19? Abba, Father, forgive the church. Remove unbelief and lethargy. Kade, kade, poko, ro, poko, sike, de, de, kazanto. Ma, kote, te, ke, sike, te, che, koro, poko, so, kade. What is death doing in the midst of your people? Death is even in the church. Death is outside the church. When it is written that death death is swallowed up in victory. When Jesus cried at death and said it is finished, when he died and rose again, where is the power that raised Jesus from the grave? Where is the power of resurrection in the church, in the families, in the nations? Arise, O Lord, let your enemy be destroyed. Let this death that is harassing the people be swallowed up completely in the nations. Open your mouth and pray. This is not the time to sleep. Death is at the door. Death is everywhere. Death is operating in the finances, in the marriages, in the bodies of people, in the nations. Satan, the Lord rebukes you. The spirit of death and hell, the Lord rebukes you. The word of God is against you. The cross of Calvary is against you. The death and resurrection of Jesus Christ is against you. What are you doing in the church of God? What are you doing in the minds of people? What are you doing in the homes of the people? What are you doing in the second heavens? What are you doing in the nations? I command the blood of Jesus to swallow up the spirit of the graveyard, the spirit of death, receive rebuke by the blood of Jesus in the nations, in the families, in the finances, in the
Thank you. We reject you, Satan. We reject your works. We reject your sicknesses. We reject your diseases. We reject death and hell. We reject your curses on the earth. We reject you in the name of Jesus. Why do they hate you great and imagine a vain thing? Kings of the earth set themselves and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord, against his anointed, say, let us break their bonds and cast away their
bones.
Let us set in the heavens and laugh at them. Abba Father, laugh at them. Abba Father, laugh at them. The Lord shall have them in derision. Then shall he speak unto them in his wrath and vex them in his sore displeasure. Yet have I set my king upon my holy hill of Zion. I will declare the decree the Lord has said unto me. At my son this day have I begotten thee. Ask of me, and I shall give thee the hidden for thy inheritance, and the uttermost parts of the earth in thy possession. Thou shalt have with the rod of iron. Thou shalt dash them in pieces like a potter's wheel. We break them with the rod of iron. We break the hidden. We break the kingdom of darkness with the rod of iron. We break death and hell in pieces with the rod of iron. We dash them in pieces. In the name of Jesus Christ, be wise not therefore, he can be instructed in judges of the earth. Serve the Lord with fear and rejoice with trembling. Kiss the Son, lest he be angry, and ye perish of the way. When his wrath is kindled but a little, blessed are all they that put their trust in him. Hallelujah. Him that we praise you. We don't want to see this death anymore. Hallelujah. I want you to be fed up with COVID-19, be fed up in your spirit, and command it to go. Fed up with the news of death every day you hear somebody you know, somebody that is close to you, somebody that is in your street. Remember, whatever we bind here on earth shall be bound in heaven. Whatever you forbid on earth shall be forbidden in heaven. We forbid death and hell. We forbid COVID-19 from killing the people. We soak this nation in the blood of Jesus. We claim the healing of this nation. We claim healing for this nation. Please pray. Claim the healing. Claim healing and health for this nation. Father, you say you will not allow your holy ones to see corruption. We have seen enough, Father. Our spirit is vexed. Make a secretity, In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Yeah, Lord, we praise you. We praise you, Lord Jesus. We praise you. Lord, I pray that you take weariness out of the souls of your people, that you take weariness out of your church, that you take fear out of your church, that you strengthen us with might by your spirit in our inner man, that we might be able to fight this battle. These are the days of battle, Father. I pray, O Lord, that our strength will not be small in the mighty name of Jesus. That we will not turn back. We will not turn back in the days of battle. We will not turn back. We will not be discouraged. We will not be weak. Oh God, we will not be weary. strengthen us, O God. Strengthen your people. Strengthen the intercessors. Strengthen the church. Strengthen every one of us. Help us to call on your name, O God. We pray for us many as are sick in the hospital right now that cannot even open their mouths, that are too weak to pray. But Father, you will help us. You will help them to fight. Don't let envy swallow your people anymore. Don't let cancer swallow your people anymore. Don't let death swallow your people anymore. Don't let violence swallow your people. Oh, Father, give us the strength that we need. Renew our strength, O God. Renew our mind, O God. Renew our anointing, O God. The anointing that we need. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. You know, I remember the king that went to Elisha on his deathbed. And Elisha told him, take bow and arrow, because war was coming. And he was told to shoot. And he shot, and he was told to also smite the ground. And he smote only twice instead of three times. And the man of God said he will not win the battle. We cannot afford to smite only twice when we should smite three times. My Father, I refuse to be weak in the day of battle. Pray for yourself. I refuse to be weak. I shall not be weak. I shall not be sleeping. I refuse to be weak emotionally, physically, spiritually. We are told to be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. Father, renew our strength. 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 Renew our strength, O God. Renew our strength. Renew our strength. Renew our strength. Renew the strength of your church. Renew our knowledge. Renew our understanding. Renew our strength. For this war, Pacote,
Amen. Jesus, I don't want to keep you, but you know, this is serious. I remember when the Lord spoke about 2020 to me, and he said there would be, that the prognosis was bleak, there would be death, there would be fire, there would be flood. And then in 2021, he told me, the prognosis is not too different. It's even now worse. But one thing he said to me at the beginning of 2020, and I can still remember his voice, tears in his voice. He said, but if you can pray, but if you can pray. Now I understand what he means by that, but if you can pray. His voice was full of tears. If you can pray. But many of us are sleeping in the days of battle. My Father, my God. My Father, my God. My Father, my God. This is like in the days of the Garden of Gethsemane. The people were sleeping. Oh Lord, because it's at the papa could a poco shop papa, but so poco shake it, a 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 poco shake it,
Do you know why COVID is killing pastors? Because they can't pray. They are tired. If you will not pray, it is dangerous. These are dangerous things. Pray for yourself, pray for your family, pray for your children, pray for the church of God. Pray, we are asking for your help. The Spirit will need your help. We need your help. Wherever your people are, in all the four corners of the earth, we are the confused, perplexed. We reject this weakness. Do you know that prayerlessness is also the walking of the spirit of death and hell? It is also a strategy of hell to be sleeping in the day of battle. It is as good as dead. My father would take the purpose so that they say revive also God, take away the death sentence. Ignite us to the fire of intercession. send the angels of deliverance. Deliverance by fire. Deliverance by fire. Deliverance by fire. Jesus, renew our minds by fire. Renew us, O God. Renew us, O God. Wherever they are hanging over our houses, over the nations, my Father, the spirit of death and hell that is making people to sleep, making the church to be fast asleep, they be asleep spiritually, emotionally, physically, and let those demons be accursed this morning. Let them be bound. Let them be set up. Should not be sleeping. Nobody can close the church because we are the church. Arise, O God, my God. Set our hearts ablaze. Baba. We praise you, Lord. We thank you, Jesus. We exalt you, Lord. Lord, do not stop to pray for us. Do not stop to pray. Do not stop to intercede for us. Do not give up on us, Father. Do not give up on us. You told the disciples in the Garden of Gethsemane that they should sleep on. We don't want to sleep on. We don't want to thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
We seal these prayers with the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
We seal our souls with the fire of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We believe that God has heard us this morning. We seal this new anointing to pray with the fire of the Holy Ghost. We seal the judgment of the spirits of slumber, the demons that have been assigned to make sure we are weak. We seal their judgment with the fire of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we thank you. We bless you. Thank you, Father. We know you have heard us. Take all the glory. We seal all the prayers we have prayed this morning in the blood of Jesus Christ.
Yes,
thank you, omnipotent God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
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 Thank you, Jesus.
Surely goodness and mercy,
shall follow us all the days of our lives.
We shall dwell,
in the house of the Lord
forever. Amen. And now,
the grace of Jesus Christ. The love of God, the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us now and forever. Thank you, Jesus.
Good morning, pastors. God bless you.
Good morning,
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.